We'll talk about the topic Applications of Biotechnology in Medicine. Recombinant human insulin called Humulin. How is it synthesized? But before that, what is insulin and how is it actually produced in our body? Insulin producing gene is located on the short arm of chromosome number 11 in human. And what is insulin? It is a proteinaceous hormone secreted by our beta cells. Where are beta cells? They are in the group of islets of Langerhans of pancreas. And what is the role of insulin? It signals the cells to take up glucose from the blood. And you know, glucose releases energy in the cells. So how does insulin work? Insulin dictates the cell to allow glucose into the cell. So these are the glucose channels which are closed here. Insulin is in the blood, glucose is in the blood, but the channel is closed. These are cell receptors. Cell membrane has receptors. So it will, the insulin will bind to the receptor. That is the signal. That means insulin is ordering the cell by binding to the receptor. The receptor has to allow opening of channel. So if it doesn't bind, the channel is closed. So when it binds, the channel is open and glucose is allowed in. So that takes care of energy production process within the cell. So how is this insulin is marketed? Why? What is the need to market insulin? So we'll talk about type 1 diabetes in brief here. And that disease is caused by insufficient insulin in the blood. So first let us see the normal process. In a human pancreatic cells, the beta cells are producing, these are the islets of Langerhans magnified, and the beta cells produce insulin. So the beta cells release insulin into the blood, which comes and dictates all the cells in our body to use up the glucose found in the blood, as we discussed there. Now persons who don't have this insulin production normal, actually what happens is their beta cells fail to secrete hormone. Reasons may be many, genetic reasons may be there, there may be different reasons like kind of illness or some other issues. Lifestyle problems may be there. So hence they have excessive amount of blood glucose because insulin is not there to dictate the cell to take up glucose. So glucose lies in the blood. The condition is called hyperglycemia. Such people show symptoms such as increased thirst, blurred vision, weight loss, even in spite of eating they have regular weight loss, frequent urination, and if untreated this can be fatal, people can die. So they have to be administered with insulin at regular intervals for all their lives. That is why we need to market insulin. So where do we get insulin from? And one more thing, before insulin was available in market, how were the diabetics taken care of? The only method was fasting and calorie restricted diets were taken so that their blood sugar level would be normal. Okay, now before biotechnology, how did insulin come into the market? What was the process? Banting and his student Best were the first one to actually extract insulin from the cells of dog, pancreatic cells of dog, and that gave an idea about why not get insulin extracted from mammals. So conventionally such insulin was used before technology came up to save the lives of diabetics. And it was obtained from slaughtering cattle and pigs. Slaughtering means killing them. They were butchered for meat purpose, etc. So their pancreatic cells were taken to get out insulin, squeeze out insulin, extract insulin. Okay. So the insulin produced in such manner differed in their structure from human insulin only by one amino acid at C-terminus. Now, if those who don't know what is C-terminus, let me just tell you, an amino acid, I have just taken two amino acids here from a protein. So, if it is a long protein, you think of such many such amino acids bound by peptide bonds. CONH forms the peptide bond when water is removed from the carboxylic end of first amino acid and the amino group of the next adjacent amino acid. So like that a long chain is there, and the extreme area where amino group is there, that is the N terminus, and the other one is the C terminus. N-terminus, C-terminus. Like that for a whole chain, one end is the N-terminus with this and the other end is the C-terminus. So near C-terminus only there was one amino acid differing in that of pig and insulin of pig and human. So in pig it was alanine and in human it was threonine. So only very close difference, so it was quite compatible with the human receptors. So that was working, though may not be so efficient. It were not, the drawbacks of such insulin was that they were not as effective as human insulin and the yield was very low. Plus you had to slaughter so many cattle and pigs to meet the demand of one diabetic patient. That was the worst part. Also rejection factors were high because anyhow that was a foreign insulin. It was not produced in the human body. Okay, so those were the drawbacks. Now, briefly if I talk about insulin production recombinantly, we have said many times that you culture human cells, get the DNA of interest, that is here insulin gene, that is the DNA of interest, culture bacterial cells, get the plasmid, you cleave both with the same restriction enzyme, ligate them and you reduce it into cells, competent cells would take, screen them and culture them, bioreactors are used. And harvest insulin and market it. This is the normal process. But when we talk about human insulin, there is slight difference for which we have to first understand the structure of insulin. The first protein, that is insulin, was the first protein whose amino acid sequencing was done, and that was done by Frederick Sanger. Protein, what is the whole amino acid sequence of a protein was studied, and this way gave way to doing recombinantly prepare insulin very easily. So the first insulin that is actually translated from our cell is known as pre-proinsulin, which is very inactive, total 108 amino acids. Okay, as the beta cells form these insulin, it is called pre-proinsulin. And this contains, pre-proinsulin contains four such chains, A chain, B chain, interlinked by C chain, and again one small chain that is the signal peptide chain. So what happens is, the first 24 amino acids that are on the signal peptide chain, this allows the whole protein to be coming out of the cell. That means signal protein leads the movement of pre-proinsulin out of the cell. Now in mammals, after the signal protein brings it out of the cell, the remaining portion is called proinsulin and that is immature and non-functional. And three peptide chains are there in proinsulin because signal protein is removed, peptide is removed, A, C and B. Now A chain has 21 amino acids, B chain has 30 amino acids and C chain has 33 amino acids. Okay, now in a normal human, this proinsulin when released, it is immature and has to be converted into mature insulin. So how is the processing done? After the signal protein is removed, is cleaved off, that contains 24 amino acids, it is cleaved off. Now proinsulin that is left in the pancreas, see this is cleaving off signal protein, peptide and what is left is proinsulin. So how is this proinsulin converted to insulin? We'll talk about that. In one sentence, if we say during maturation, C peptide is removed. What remains is A and P, A and B chain. Now, this A and B chain should be interlinked before C is cleaved off because C was joining them. Now, they have to be joined before it is cleaved off. So, what happens is chain A and chain B's cysteine amino acid, cysteine, you can see cysteine amino acids of chain and B at certain positions. That position should be understood. You can go through the numbering. They are bond through disulfide bridges. Disulfide bonds are formed between them. Okay, between A and B. Two such disulfide bonds are formed. Then also, there is one more disulfide bond between amino acids cysteine of chain A. That is 6th one and the 11th one. So with this, the A and B chain are linked together and now the C chain is cleaved off. Mature insulin is formed. Okay, so mature insulin contains only chain A and chain B with three disulfide bridges and the total amino acid is 21 plus 30, that is 51. Now, how after this was understood, how was the process of recombinantly preparing human insulin done. So synthetic human insulin is named as Humulin. The brand name with which it is marketed is Humulin. It was an American company called Eli Lilly. In the year 1983, they started marketing Humulin. So they were the one to actually synthesize this recombinant insulin. How? As we discussed earlier, it was just not a simple one-step process. Understanding that only A and B chains are functioning in mature insulin, they had the idea of artificially synthesizing only A and B chain separately. Why synthesize C chain when it is not needed for a patient? Okay, so what they did is by a process of getting mRNA out of the cells, mRNA coding for chain A and B, cDNAs were synthesized. All that is a long process. We are not going to the depth of it now. And how such genes were introduced into E. coli cells and all. So first, introducing the chain A, gene coding for chain A into a vector with the ampicillin resistance genes and all for acting as a selectable marker, selecting the transformants from non-transformants and all that we have discussed in other videos. Insulin B chain, insulin coding B chain given into another plasmid. So such two separate recombinant plasmids are formed. Then when they are ligated and all, that is the recombinant plasmids are introduced into cells. The recombinant cells are screened and then they are cultured in different fermenters. So both the cells, chain A and chain B, are separately produced. You can read here what I am explaining. So they are separately produced, and then after they are separately produced, they are mixed together. They are mixed together in such a condition that sulfide bonds, disulfide bonds would be formed between those amino acids as discussed in the previous screen and also on chain A. So this gives them a folding. Okay, when such bridges are formed between amino acids, the protein gets a folding. So these two chains were extracted, mixed, combined by making disulfide bonds, and this is how Humulin was marketed. Okay, this was purified of course and then it was marketed. So I hope that topic is clear. Please comment. If any doubt, you can ask.